Hey, hello and welcome back. So I'm back in the deep lands and I decided to come up top so you can actually see down there. That's where the portal is. I'm on Y70, ground is Y20. So I came up into the ceiling of the deep lands and I've been mining around. And one of the things I noticed was that these things are kind of the special ingot or whatever for this area. They show up in the ground in this stone above Y70 or above. And I can also get them as my reward for mining whenever I break deep stone. So I've been getting kind of a lot of these. Now, the thing I don't get about them is these are supposed to be kind of like item containers where you're supposed to be able to put them on the ground and break them and you're supposed to get something. I've broken, I don't know how many of them. I haven't got anything yet. So I'm wondering if it has to be broken with either an advent pick or a normal pick, like a normal Minecraft pick. But I haven't been able to get back yet, or I haven't gone back yet to do it. And one of the other things that happened is, let's see, I think it was this row right here, all the way down at the end, which you kind of can't see because it's dark down there. I stopped just shy of the end because I wanted to have this happen when I got, you know, when I was recording. I was at 99 and I had like a sliver left, you know, maybe a line off of one of those numbers, like, you know, the width of the one left. And I went and I it's like, okay, I'm going to do one more and then I'll stop. And that should be just enough. The next hit should do it. I broke that section with the hammer and I leveled up. Whole bunch of music played. And now for some reason, when I mine stuff, oh, hey, cool. They do spawn in here. I wasn't sure if they did. Maybe it is light level. They hadn't been spawning before. But now when I mine, so this thing also got a level up on it. So it has a mining speed of 24, but it insta-mines this stuff. I mean, I don't know how well it's going to show up on YouTube with all the darkness, but I'm just basically walking forward with these things, and it just rips it up. And it didn't do that before. It happened, I kind of finished a line, and then I turned around, and I started to go back, and it just ripped a hole right in the wall in front of me and went, you know, a lot deeper than I intended it to. So I don't know if that's because I hit level 100 or what, but it's actually kind of cool because I can just kind of walk. And, oh, actually, we didn't get all of that, did we? One of the other things that's in this dimension that I haven't seen before is this stuff. It's the charged runium ore. So it's the next tier up of the stuff we can get in the overworld. Oops. Okay, it's a little bit harder to do precision mining with this thing now. But I've been sending it all back. I mean, I have done a ton of exploring and mining over the last probably 12 hours, I think. And like as you can see, I think when I came in here earlier today, I was level 96 and a half in foraging, and now I'm 100. So I've been digging a lot. I mean, you can see this area. I've hollowed this area out. I dug this tunnel. You can kind of see. Goes way, way, way down here and stops. What else did we do? We just got like a basic structure built. You can kind of, this is the level I'm on right now, so you can kind of see the area that's dug out here. We built, I want to say it's one room wide and it's tall enough to get just under the portal using our standard room structure. So we built that as kind of like a safer area when you come out of the portal, so you're not just, you know, landing on the ground with things all around you. One thing we do have to kind of watch out for is Y70 is within range of holes as far as the roof goes here, because we are in the ceiling of the deep lands. So if we slide down a little bit, you can kind of see how it's kind of craggy here. So where I'm at, I've been cutting over, but you can see way over there kind of that it's higher there. So when you're running through at this level, you have to watch out that you don't walk off an edge. Luckily with this armor set on, it doesn't really matter all that much, but it's still kind of a little dangerous sometimes. Where's the ladder? There it is. I want to pop back through. I'm going to get back to the base, then I'll be back, and I want to show you some armor I bought from a merchant here. I'm not sure where. I don't see any on the map right now. They just randomly spawn in clusters. You'll kind of see them floating around. So far we've seen, I want to say it was like a priest. I think that's what Newt called it. I didn't look at it to see what it was. There's also been one for foraging. So basically it looks like a lot of the skills up there, there were at least three different ones in this area. They just literally, your standard NPC, they spawn a single or in like groups of five or six. and they're dependent on the different skills, but you have to be level 100 to use them, and I bought that stuff. So I'm going to run back and pull it out of the chest, and I'll be back once I get it. All right, and we're back in the base. Couple things I want to show you first. Hopefully my frame rate will hold out. Newt upgraded a lot of our chests to these crystal chests because they were cheaper, because we have very little obsidian right now. I have no idea why, where all that went, but... So my frame rate's kind of fluctuating a little bit around here because of all those. I got these. Like I said, I've been doing... Oops, gotta turn that off. Can't have that on right now. Show caves. I had to have that on in the deep lands where I couldn't see anything. All right, so what I did. Let's zoom out. I explored everything over here. You can see village. Ooh, too far. That was one of the nodes. I think this was the village that was kind of screwed. It's way up on the mountain, so it's got these weird griffin things that are immune to arrows. And there are guards who shoot arrows. Not working out very well for them up here. There was also one of those Thaumcraft monuments that has the chest on it and the wisp spawner in it. And it's there. So wisps and zombies and all sorts of stuff spawn there at night. This walled village, I don't remember if there's anything weird about that one. That's our little outpost in the south. Another village right there. I found a taint biome, so we got one there. And we got another one right here. So here's our base. Southeast of our base is a taint biome. This village is already, this area here in the lake is pretty much already growing and tainted. There's already tainted villagers in it. It's slowly spreading into the northern part of the village there. So what I did was I went in here into this magical forest, something like that. You'll notice we've got, the little light blue dots. Those are the silverwood trees. How there are, none right around here. I went in here and I just strip mined them all out. If they didn't have a node in them, if they had a node, I left the node and just stuck a torch on it so I could find it in the dark later. And I stripped them all the way to the ground. I came out of it with, 10 saplings, so it really didn't produce an awful lot. But I explored all over here. I did nothing over there. I did something else. Where did I go? I went all over the place. So I kind of went around here and all over the place. But I filled those chests that are in there probably 3 times, and I killed anything that I found. So any animal, whatever, I killed them. And so I got sheep, and I got a chicken trophy. Apparently like 1% drop rate, but if you right-click the chicken, it makes chicken noise and gives you an egg. The sheep, it baws like a sheep. So it's kind of neat. I already put one egg in here. That's how come we have 2 chickens. But so I did that. I'm trying to think what else I did. Oh, one other thing. Let me go over there real quick. Man, yeah, these things twitch a bit when I get near them. While I was exploring, I found some more spawners. So we've got a skeleton spawner right there. And right below it, we got a cave spider spawner. Or a cave spider. I think it's a standard spider spawner. It's the ones that come underneath the great wood trees when they have cobwebs on them. So there's one there, and there's one right down there. I'm probably going to take the skeleton spawner out because, seriously, I do not need bone and arrows anymore. And if you stand here long enough, it fills up. The primary reason we got those spider spawners was because it works a lot faster than the cotton farms as far as creating wool. Now, what we were originally coming over here to look at is this stuff. It's the foraging armor. You have to have, you can see it says it needs, requires level 100 foraging. I have that now. And I also need to remember I am no longer immune to dying if I trip and fall off a ledge. And this is what the NPCs look like. This is kind of cool. And he's actually got that symbol on him. So let's see. It's still got full armor. So 3, 8, 6, 3. Yeah, so it's still full suit of armor, which is kind of cool. It doesn't have the fall damage reduction, so I really need to watch out for that. But according to this, the set bonus is that it grants double drop rates. Well, I'm... level 100, which you have to be, so high level drop rate drops. I'm not sure what that means, but I kind of want to find out. But what I want to do first, I want to test out a couple of those deep cases and see if we can get anything out of them. 1, 2, as you can see, what do we got? I got a bunch of crafting stations, stencil tables, stuff like that. I ripped down so many smelteries while I was out there. Ooh, these. So we got some more Christevias, but these came up while we were mining in the deep lands. I haven't looked at what the ancient cavern is. And it's nighttime. I think it might be one of the high level ones that you can't get to easily. I haven't looked it up yet to see what it is, but let's try this real quick. Let's take one of these. Pickaxe. Oh, subterranean chestplate. 100% of melee damage you take to the attacker. Holy crap. Okay, so if you've got one of their picks, it works, but one of the Tinker's picks, it doesn't. And it broke immediately. It's not like I had to actually hack on it at all. So either that's because of my foraging level, I'm getting some type of bonus I'm not aware of, or it's just how they work. All right, let's crack some more open. Let's see what we get. And, oh my goodness. Deep bow, 34, heavily reduced speed. Consumes holy arrows. Sounds cool. Let's put this stuff away so we can get to the rest of it. So, chest, helmet, legs. We don't have the boots for that set. We've got a couple deep bows now. Crystals aren't that big a deal. We'll just toss the copper coins in there. I got a void barrel attached to the other end. Not that it always works, but it's there. Put these here. And, okay. Let's get rid of less of them. See if we get less of them. Rest of them and see if we get anything else, because it's kind of interesting. It is nice, actually, that I can store them up and not have to use them until I get back to base. All right. Well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to crack the rest of these open. If I get anything different, I'll be back. Otherwise, I want to go over to the deep lands and see what this armor does. All right, we're back in the deep lands. Let's give this thing a shot. Okay, so I got 30. Wow. I think I figured out what's going on when my hammer upgraded the last time. It got more redstone. It's now at 24.66 speed, which it must be along with the haste 3 I've got on me from being in here, the insta-mine thing. So, okay, so those are normal, but it seems like the high-level shards were definitely more than we got before. Yeah, we're definitely getting a lot of those. That's interesting. So it's useful to wear, I would say it's useful to wear if you're going to be, doing this. So like, maybe if I go into, what does it say specifically from higher level foraging? Yeah, so like maybe if I'm in the nether, I'll wear it while I'm working, because then it has a chance of giving me, yeah, see, there's one of those holes. And I don't have that armor on, so death. Yeah, maybe I'll wear that when I'm in the nether and see if it has a higher chance of giving me anything in there. I don't think it does, but it'd be worth checking out just in case. So let's, for now, switch back to this armor because I like being able to jump and not die. So put that back in there. How many did it use any of our uses? No, I don't think it did because we didn't get hit, which is kind of cool. The gray bag I did have with my fish going in, or I was putting the fish in from the fish farm, fish trap thing. I linked this at new bag to it, and I just stuck some food in it, and I stuck a whole bunch of extra dev nulls in here, along with my two diamond dollies. That way, if I need it, I can access it quickly, and while I'm not actually there, you know, I don't have to run back to base to get it. So that's kind of what I've been going for. But right now, what I'm going to do is see if I can go find a reliable source of lava somewhere and take some water and see if I can get some more obsidian, because right now we need a lot more obsidian and we don't have any. I used it all up, and I used up probably more than I should have, because now our complete supply is gone and we have like nothing. So I'm going to see if I can do that, and once I get some of that stacked up, I'll be back. And we're back. So I ended up with 11, almost 12 full stacks of obsidian after emptying out a lava lake way down on, I think it was like level 10, between 10 and 11. So I've got a bunch of it left still. I've got some of it on me. I've obsidianed the entire floor, including under the node and around it. And I've just slapped it all over. That way, eventually, when we crack this thing, we'll be able to see where its actual radius is by the number of slabs it eats. So that's kind of the theory. Right now, what I need to do is get a stack on top of it. Probably, you know, 15, yeah, at least 15 blocks tall, maybe 16 or 17. And it's going to be a chute straight down to the bottom where eventually we'll punch a hole in the top. The idea for that is we'll put our garbage can way up there with like an ender chest, a hopper, and an item grate. Now, anything that we put into that ender bag chest or whatever just falls right down and gets sucked into the node. Now, to try and be able to see what we're doing for that node, we need to have a hallway to it. That's the part I'm not quite sure about. Because we need to be able to have a window in so we can actually see the node itself. But I kind of want to keep as much of this area open as possible. I won't be able to use the top because it's going to be for the garbage chute. Can't use the bottom because that'd be a death wish. It would just yank you right up into it, depending on how you hit it. Or it would just kind of stick you in the air and you wouldn't be able to move. So I'm thinking it'll either come off of here or it'll come off the back. I'm not really sure which one yet. Now that level down there is the floor. Yeah, it's the floor of the level below us. So it's possible maybe we go down to that floor and kind of run a tunnel over and then kind of have some steps up. But even that may not work because of the way the node pulls. It could get you kind of stuck in the air, which really wouldn't be all that helpful. Get rid of those guys. They annoy me. So do you. And you. So that's kind of what I'm looking at right now, is trying to figure out how to do that. Where do I want to have that hallway? I might just do it, you know, straight over where we kind of walk down into it and walk over. But I'm looking at having... No, I think we're going to do it off the back. That leaves this entire front area open for this kind of observation area. So it'll either be off the back or off this side, because that's kind of where the largest part of the wall is right now. So we can do that way. Maybe we'll run it off this side. Then we can kind of have the open area here go down to a stairwell. We'll do that. Let's see. So now what we have to do is start to get the garbage chute built. Now this is the part I'm not entirely sure about. Let's see how my ender pearling does. Eh, perfect. So now I'm trapped. But because I'm here, I can get some of the obsidian laid in. And will it let me? Oh, hey, it will. Cool. This is going to sting. Nope. Not going back in there. Ah, nuts. Yeah, can I get loose? Kind of. Not quite. Well, let's see. If we go this way, we can run all the way around it. That's not very helpful. All right, we're going to have to use another ender pearl. So let's aim for the wall. And let's get out of here. Ow, I'm almost dead. That'd be awkward. Die again, lose all my stuff. This stuff I got off some Ursas. They're kind of like dog things off in a spruce forest I found. Not very good food. Kind of junky, really. But maybe we can use it to pad our food here. See if we can get the chili to... Nope. Yeah, we'll just take some steak. I killed so many cows and pigs. And then let's make sure we get our health back. We will use some beef jerky since we have a ton of it. There we go. Now what we need to do... I missed some slabs there. It's going to bug me. I'll have to fix that later. We need to get on top of that thing again and plug that hole with something so it's not able to pull us in, or at least not able to pull us down all the way where we get stuck. I think the easiest way to do that is going to be to kind of scaffold over to it and then see if we can get that to work. So let me get that built, and I'm going to see if I can get another layer on there, and then I'll be back. All right, so it has been a little over probably 36 hours or so since I recorded the last cut. And in that time, I have got quite a bit done. You can kind of see some of it out there. Of course, this being a 3-day weekend, okay, right now it is actually Monday. I completely forgot that today was Monday because I didn't work today. So this video has not been released when it was supposed to. Sorry about that. What we're going to do, as you can see in the distance there, I've flattened everything on this island and raised it all up to level 65. So that was kind of one of the things I worked on. And that black right there, that's actually seared stone slabs. That's kind of what I'm calling Project Parking Lot. What we are doing is we are going to pave this entire area. It will all be this black material outside of the base structures. So you can kind of see all of this area has been flattened all the way up to here. I think this is at the right height. This will have to be brought up still. This area over here still needs to be raised up. This either needs to be covered or something. I flattened this island down. That one's still there and that one's still there. I haven't done anything with those yet. So this is basically one massive spawning bed, as you can see, because I removed all of the slabs that I had out there. Come on, where are you? Nope. So everything has just been kind of appearing all over the place. I got the tube ready that we can use to view the actual node. we can come over here and we can take a look at that. Don't want to get too close. Okay. You can see the things falling into it right now. Those are falling into from above. I brought the trash can set up that we had over in the base. Come on. Out of range. I brought that set up over here and I put it at the top of this. So it's actually way up there. It's on the same level. I think it's one level below those flashing lights. I kind of figured this was a tall chimney structure, so it needed some lights to go with. So what we did was redstone. The ones I used were these circling neon redstone. Just some iron and some redstone, so I had to make four of them. They're around the edges there just to kind of give it a little bit of a blinky thing. Not really sure how I feel about it. Not sure about this entire setup here. It needs to be here to keep the dropping structure out of range of this thing and make sure the items fall straight down. So that's kind of why it's there. You can see I'm just dumping glass bottles in there right now. I put enough blocks of obsidian in front of this thing to keep me far enough away from the node. So you can see the node is on that block right there. So then we're 1, 2, 3 from the actual node. From this point, I can actually walk out. Now, one thing I am noticing is I thought I had all of this slabbed. I wonder if that little bugger ate it all. It may have. So we'll have to kind of watch that. I'm not really sure how. Wow, things got a little. This isn't quite right in some of these spots. I think it's still got a little bit of suction that I can't reach. So let's get rid of some of these guys so we can. I made another set of bolts, and I'm using this to using these knights to level them. I have to be careful right now because I'm shooting the wall, and because they're not. They don't regenerate crazy fast yet. They've only managed to get up to repair 4, so they're still a little on the slow side. But they do almost as much damage as the bolts I have already, which is kind of nice. Now back to what we were doing. Let's put this stuff away before I see something else shiny and get distracted. All right. So as you can see, maybe not. Let's actually sleep so it's daylight, so you can actually see. So let's drop. We get this taken care of. Nobody else is on right now, so it should shift over pretty quick. Okay. Now. We done? Okay. Now we can see. And dead. Right here, I have block breakers wrapped all the way around that thing, touching each piece of obsidian I want removed. It was quite a bit of an expenditure, really, even given the fact that we get diamonds from mining. Each one of those block breakers takes a diamond pickaxe, so you can see I've got quite a bit of them there. So I've got 18, 19, I got 21 of them. So we're looking at, 64 diamonds it took to make that thing right there. And I actually made a couple extra ones so I could test with. I stuck them up and I put several blocks in front of them, and I activated them to make sure they would only eat the block in front of them, because seriously, if I flip that switch and it destroys that node, I'm probably going to, freak out. But we'll see. Now, I'm going to use the repeater because I want to make sure the signal gets there. Those are my extras. So the idea here is that I've got a lever, I got a repeater, I got some more of our redstone paste, because apparently redstone paste does not interact with normal redstone, which is kind of a bummer. But, So what the idea here is to do is to get that fully tacked up onto here, get our lever there. Now, no, stop it. I'm going to run this over, connect it to there, remove the slabs around the bottom block breakers, get them pasted in, connect this line up last. Basically, it's like working with explosives. We're going to connect the trigger at the very end. Once that's done, we should be able to flip this switch. All those block breakers should eat that obsidian. Did I actually line that up right, or am I off by one? Okay, no, they're lined up. I had a moment there. So you can see the ones on this. Hello. The ones on this side will remove this entire side. The ones on that side, that entire side. Those three right there will just remove what's left over. The rest I'm going to deal with, I'm not entirely certain, because there are going to be one or two pieces on the inside that it leaves, but those are kind of connected to the tunnel, so I'm leaving those for now. So that's what we're kind of aiming for right here. Is my hope is that when I flip that switch, it will eat that obsidian, throw it out the back, which I really don't care about. You know, it's Obsidian. I have a few more stacks. Losing the Block Breakers is going to be a kind of a pain in the butt. I may see if I can rescue them, but I'm not entirely sure that's going to be a wise idea. You know, I've lost enough stuff, so I may just sacrifice those and then go mining later. But what I'm going to do is get this whole thing wired up and then come back, and then we will flip the switch and see what happens. All right, this is our moment of truth here. On the plus side, moving again. On the plus side, I was looking in the deep lands the other day while I was mining and leveling my pickaxe and building and exploring and, you know, leveling the new crossbow bolts. I found another hungry note. So I guess to say one thing, this is the first time I've ever found two. It's rare enough that I've found one in a world, but to find two is just plain crazy. And it's not even that far from where we started. I think it's like 100 or 200 blocks from where we were in, where we came through for that portal. So it's kind of neat. At least we have a backup, although I hope to not need to use it. I don't think we need to use 2 points there. Now, this is kind of the moment of truth here as to whether or not this works or I end up destroying this node. So like I said, I did run several tests with different blocks in front of these block breakers, and they only ate one block in front of them. But let's see what happens. Okay. Look at him go. I wonder if we can rescue some of those without getting ourselves killed. Let's see. I think I have... Yeah, I do have some ender pearls. All right. Let's do stupid thing number one for the day. Well, maybe number one. We'll see. And can I reach you? I swear if I hit that node, I'm going to have a meltdown probably. And can I? Nope, don't grab me. Quit being so grabby. Alright, so that's that. Can we... Alright. Now, one of the reasons I left all these slabs in here instead of removing them is I want to find out what the actual radius is for this thing. Because, like you can see, there are, like right here, where I'm standing, it's not pulling me. But when I did my test initially, it did. So I'm not sure if I just managed to, you know, goof up my testing, or if the radius is different, or, you know, what basically why it's not working the way I expected it to. And that's kind of what I'm trying to do here, is figure that out. Because I did a little bit of research, and it looks like blocks of hardness 5 or higher, or actually I think maybe it's higher than 5, are eaten by this thing. So that's why obsidian is safe. You know, diamond blocks, anvils, emerald blocks, iron blocks, you know, a lot of that stuff. And, oh man, I think we managed to save almost all of them. That's awesome. I can actually use those for a farm later, which is cool. The reason I was kind of checking that is I wanted to see if the seared stone that I'm using over there, if that had a hardness, because it's difficult to break. I mean, you know, even using my crazy little hammer here, it takes a second or so to break that stuff. I mean, this pick, really slow breaking it. Not as slow as breaking obsidian, but neither is an iron block. So I'm hoping that it's one of those things where it's actually has a hardness where I can use it. Because if that's the case, it means some of this structure can be ripped out and used for, used as seared stone. Okay, so there's our node. I can't scan it yet because apparently when it ate the trees and the grass, it pulled in some life to it, and I have very few items in Thaumcraft scanned yet. Let's see if we can do this here. Can we get this block and the block under it? Because, okay. I heard a popping sound, and I thought maybe I'd done something, but it's eating the slabs around it. So let's see if we can get this out of here. And I get the feeling this is going to be... Or I want to use my hammer, but I don't want to risk hitting that node. I'm going to be horribly boring here. So let me crack a couple pieces of this obsidian out of here. I want to use the pick, even though it's slower, because it's much more controlled. And once I get those blocks popped out, I'll be back. And it's daytime, and we're back. I am noticing a problem right off the bat. There's a hole there. There's a hole over there. There's two holes right there. There's a hole there, there. This thing has a radius larger than I thought. Now, I thought it was going to be the, I'm guessing maybe I'm too close. I might be, 14 blocks might actually be you know, I may have counted it wrong. I'm guessing that this right here is probably the 14th block, but as it stands, just in case, I started moving stuff out of this area here because it is starting to look like it's going to be eating that area shortly. So we'll kind of have to see. Right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this thing, I'm going to keep it loaded. I may, let's take a look here. That's H. Let's take a look. I may build one of these things. These things, crazy cheap. I have a ton of these gems now from the deep lands, probably like 4 stacks of them. And Limonite, yeah, don't really, you know, not a shortage on that. All I have to do is make an enchanting table. So I may build one of these, stick it up on top of that thing with a 3x3 radius on it. Or the 3x3 setting to keep this entire area loaded, because if you look, this would be the center, so it would be sitting in this chunk here. So a 3 wide would give us, it would cover the entire circle that it's in. Technically, I only really need like a 2, but I want this area to be fully loaded. I want this thing to eat everything around it so I can see where its radius actually is and try and figure that out, because once I find that out, I need to contain it. And then I'll need to rebuild the wall, because obviously this one's incorrect, at least in a couple spots, because I'm noticing, like, you know, right there, it ate it, but it's not eating those. It punched a hole right there, but again, not right here. It took out the central single there, but not over there. So I'm guessing it's just, we're going to need to leave it loaded for a while and just see what it takes out and then readjust the wall from that point. But this is what I was looking to get done. We got the stack made for the trash to feed the node. We got an access port so I can get into it and check its status, because I don't really want to get eaten by that thing. And that's it. We got it removed. The floor's done. All that fun stuff. So this is pretty much it for the episode now. Next time when I come back, I'm going to hopefully have this area. I'm going to hopefully have letting it eat in this entire area, and we'll go from there. But I'm not sure it'll have enough time, but we'll see. And then back next time. Thank you for watching.